What's going on, Ground Roots Outdoors? That's right, it's Aaron Morstead, and we're back here with round three of the new, well, not new, two-year-old, but new from the store for me, Bone Crusher, Bone Collector 370. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, and already, it's only been about a couple weeks, and I'm already got my first upgrade on it. Check it out. There it is. It's the LUMIX Killer Instinct 1x5 power speed ring, and I've got it set on 350, but I know I'm going to have to make adjustments and stuff, but we're just zeroing it into to 30 yards, 20 and 30 yards, because 20 and 30, from what they say on this thing, this crossbow is fast enough that there's not any, hardly any drop, if any, at 20 yards versus 30 yards. We'll see about that. It's hard for me to believe that 20 and 30 yards, there's no drop. I mean, I guess. We'll see. All right. Shot number one. Let's see if we got it zeroed in. And remember, we're using the Killer Instinct Hyper. They're 390 grains, but we weighed them, which I still have to show you guys that. I weighed them, and they were actually 388, 387, and 388. 25.1 grams. I'll do the conversion here in a minute. 25.3, 4, 3, 25.2. All right, so I'll show you how to do the conversion here in a minute.
Pretty consistent, 387, 388. And I just actually got a box of the Hyper 390s. Yeah, my wife bought them from Cabela's, so I don't even know how much she paid for them, but wish she would have talked to me first. We'll see. Anyway. Shot number one. Oh, and by the way, all screws that from the beginning when I told you they were stripped out and stuff on the heads and everything, and I had to recut that one down and stuff. So far, we've ran probably about 50 shots for this thing, and they still haven't backed out. That's probably because of the Loctite blue. So, I don't care. It worked. All right. Shot number one.
Technical difficulties. All right, there we go. Okay. Way high. Way high. Got to make an adjustment.
So windage seems to be okay, but the elevation was way high, and I thought I made a better adjustment than that, but I didn't. So here we go.
All right, here we go. Shot two. Tell you what, we're gonna drop it about one or two clicks, and we're gonna move it to the right about one or two clicks. Literally, click, click. Now,
I like this scope a lot better because it's a dial, not one that you gotta use a screwdriver or a coin or something like that. So anyway, I'm gonna make my adjustments, and then we'll take a walk, and I'll show you what's going on so far.
All right, take the walk. All right, yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, this is the first one, way stinking high, and it wasn't too far off center, so I went ahead and I brought it over like two clicks, literally two clicks, and I dropped it down about two clicks. So I want precision.
All right, here we go. Let's see if we got it dialed up now.
Kids and their homework.
I may have pulled that one a little bit, so we'll shoot again and see. Shot two. I'm gonna go pull those bolts and take you with me and see what we got.
Yep. Okay, so this was the first one, so I kind of pulled it, I guess. Here's my second one. I did kind of yank it a little bit, so let's go ahead and see what's up. We'll shoot some more through it and we'll go from there. Stay hanging there.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, when you know this pig is dialed up. All right, let's take a walk. First shot was just a hair to the right, so I moved it over a couple clicks. Shot, hit a bullseye, pulled it, shot it again. Here we go. Take the walk.
Try not to step any landmines. And for those of you that know what have dogs, you know what landmines are. There you go. Little high, but that was me. But the right was not me. Look at that bullseye, and it's stuck in the fence, by the way. Oh no, it's not. Sweet. I think I did it. As you guys can see, it's my stand needs a couple more screws in it.
A carpenter I am not, but hopefully you liked seeing the new upgrade. It's got the speed ring on it, and so we're gonna head out to Choctaw Archery in the next few days, and you're gonna see exactly what the speed ring can do, and we'll be seeing exactly how many feet per second this thing is shooting, and that's how you make your adjustment on your speed ring. Is now you don't mess with your windage or your elevations. Now it's the speed ring to get it sighted in at 50 yards. And once you got it sighted in at 50 yards, you're golden. So you'll have your 30, your 20 and 30, 20/30 set up the way they talk. We'll see. And then your 50. And then once you got your 20/30 set up and your 50 set up, you're golden. So stay tuned. Speed ring time. Here we go. All right, Grand Roots Outdoors. We're out here at my father-in-law's. We didn't make it to Choctaw Archery, but that's okay. I got plenty of room to stretch this thing out. We're gonna take a 20 and a 30 to see if what they say is true about this speed ring, that they're the same, and we'll cure that problem real quick, or we'll prove it. So first of all, we're gonna take a 20, and then we're gonna take a 30. And unfortunately, I forgot my camera stand, so hang in there. All right, as you can see, I got my little helper since he wants to not do what he's supposed to do at school. So, all right.
Two shots.
All right, so that's 20, and that was pretty good. So the target's at an angle, so that's why the arrows are that way.
Only get one.
And so we're gonna pull these, and then we're gonna go to 30 and see if the 20 and the 30 are the same. So hang in there.
There you go, 30 yards, there's the target.
And we're gonna shoot this thing and see what happens. I'm gonna try and do it with, oh, gotta have an arrow in there. The anti-lock thing works great.
See. All right, same one, aiming at the bottom right.
And you got one?
Okay, so that's low. So sorry about that, but it's low. About an inch low, but we'll see. We'll shoot another one, so hang in there. All right, aiming at the bottom right, so forgive the shakiness.
And you got a shot?
Yeah, they're low. All right, we're gonna take a walk, and something tells me that this thing is not what they say. 30 yards and 20 yards, because I just saw a puff of grass go up, so something tells me I just went underneath the target and hit low. Yeah, right there. Look at that.
I pull it.
Hang on. I think that low one was me, though. But that one, we're going to adjust that, and we'll see when we go to 30. Like the rules say, we'll go to 30, and we'll shoot the 20, and it should be right on, and blah, 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 and then we'll go 50. Hang in there. All right, here we go. Shooting again. We're going to try something because it's kind of looks like it's uphill, even though the rangefinder says it's not. So we're going to aim up at the top of the target. Still the bottom right. We're going to back this truck up here.
Our truck?
No, I'm just nothing. Never mind. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not liking this, but whatever. Anyway, it's what it is. So I'm hitting low. And I don't know, we'll see. Oh well, there's your good grouping anyway. Stay tuned. I don't think this is true, but. All right, ladies and gentlemen, 50 yard walk. All the way up here to the target. And we'll see where we're hitting, and we'll make our adjustments based on the speed ring. It says you're supposed to turn it. I don't know about that, but we'll see. Oh yeah, they're both low. I don't know why it's hitting right, but maybe the wind. So we're gonna have to turn it down a little bit. Yeah, I see that. All right, but they're there. Yep. Number one bites the dust. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not liking this too well because it's, I don't know, man. I need to stretch this thing out a little bit, but we'll see. Hang in there. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So what I did, I don't know if you can see this or not, is right here on the speed ring, I was set at 370 because that's the IBO of the crossbow. I went down, I always go too far, but I went to 350. So let's see what happens on the 350. And then if I had to turn it up, that'd be great. If not, I'm right where I'm supposed to be. So stay tuned, here we go. All right, again, aiming at the small dot in the middle at the bottom. Still hitting low. Way low.
You do move away a little
bit. Well, let's do that. Well, let's see. So I turned it to 340 just to see what happens. So we'll see. All right, here we go. Go again. Come on, dumb dumb. All right, there we go. Same spot, 350, bottom center. I turned it from 350 to 340, so let's see. There it is.
You got it, top.
All right, so we're hitting left, but our windage is good. So I'm gonna shoot a couple more, and we'll pick up here in a minute. All right, 50 yards, let's see what happens. We'll come up here. My windage is good. Or not windage, but elevation I think is good. So we are at 50 yards. That scope, guys and girls, if that speeds of this thing is what it says it is nowhere near 370, and I'm not happy. So first one I shot was low. I had it set at 350. I turned it to 340, and now it's hitting perfect, other than the windage, and I can fix that at home. So stay tuned. We're gonna shoot again and see if we're dialed up. All right, here we go. Now that we are on, so we're gonna aim at the bottom dot, the small dot at the bottom in the middle. Yep, perfect. Hot dog. No, we don't have a hot dog. Hot dog, I said hot dog in a good way. That we're dialed up. Maybe, hopefully. All right, one more. Again, like I said, bottom middle, little spot. I pulled it or pushed it, whatever. It hit low, but I think it's where it needs to be. So we're gonna move up to 20 yards and we'll see if it's dialed up at 20, and then I'll give you my final thoughts. Stay tuned. All right, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not too happy because the IBO on this thing is 370 and I've had to turn this speed ring down to 340. That's 20 feet per second less. And I'm shooting the 390, the Hyper, the Killer Instinct Hyper that came with it, that they swear up and down that that's what they were shooting 370 with. No, not happening, Cap. So we're gonna shoot this again, make sure we're dialed up, and then we're done. And I'll see you in a minute. All right, there it is. Yeah, this was my second one. I kind of pushed it because I was trying to watch where it went. That one hit perfect. So 50 is dialed up. So let's go back to 20 and see if that 20 is dialed up. And we're rocking and rolling. Hang in there. All right, here we go. The tried and true. See if 20 yards is ready to go. And we are going to aim at that bottom center. And we're going to let it fly. I think that was good. All right, here we go. Last one. Noah, if this is it right here, dude, if this hits. And I don't care if I hit my other bolt or not, because this will be totally worth it. Nah, we'll do the middle top, the small one at the middle top. Yes, I love it.
Yes, you won, Aaron.
Yes, I did win.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we just shot 20, 30, and then shot the 50. And the 50's lined up, 20's lined up. I shot 20, so we're going to take the walk. I'm going to show you what happened. Walk at 20 yards. I know I'm a dork. Ladies and gentlemen, right there, I will take that every time. So ladies and gentlemen, what does that say? That speed ring, either it's off a little bit or that crossbow's way off, which I'm not too pleased with because it's supposed to be 370 and I turned it down all the way to 340, which 340 is still smoking, guys. I mean, I'm not complaining too much other than the fact that I had to take a 20 feet per second drop. That's not good. So anyway, I like the upgrade though. I like the scope, and I'm looking forward to getting after it this next deer season. So hang in there, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, it's gonna be a long review. Here we go. If you like what you see, hit your thumbs up. If you like what you see and you're not a subscriber, hit the subscribe button and the little bell for notifications. That way you get all the videos when they come out. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Love you guys. We are at now 140 subscribers. You guys are awesome. Stay tuned to next time. See ya.